Hey everybody, how you doing out there? It is Mr. Bookman, and I will be reading The Adventures of Moose and Mr. Brown by Paul Smith and illustrated by Sam Usher. Please enjoy. The Adventures of Mr. Moose and Mr. Brown. I'd like to introduce you to my good friends of mine. The first is Mr. Brown. Like, Mr. Brown is a fashion designer. Mr. Brown is in charge of my studio, which is in London, Covent Garden. He is a gentle boss. He's charismatic, caring, and I look forward to coming to work every day, knowing that I will greet him with a smile and a wave. The second person I'd like to introduce you to is Moose. I met Moose by chance when he first arrived in London from Alaska. When we first met, Moose took an instant interested in my world of design and creation. I was immediately struck by how curious Moose was and how fabulous he was by all the things he encountered as he went on his day. Moose works for Mr. Brown in my studio, alongside lots of other wonderful characters. My studio is a busy place with lots going on all of the time. The phone never stops ringing, and the door never stops swinging. The studio is jam-packed full of things. Everything from keys to bikes, books to bunnies, and lots of them. Moose and Mr. Brown have the perfect temperament for busy studio. They find inspiration in everything that surrounds them. And in the busy studio, that means there is plenty inspire them. I hope you enjoyed this story. Paul Smith. This is Moose passport photo. This is Monty. Or is it other way around? Who knows? They're identical twins, but Moose is very tidy and organized, and Monty isn't. You could tell by their baby photos here. They are in their pushchairs. Monty is the one upside down. And this is Monty falling off his potty. Despite their difference, the twins were very close. They had never been apart until the day they left Alaska and lost each other in the airport. They were going on holidays to London. Moose got on the right plane and Monty didn't. Moose felt so alone without his twin. A tear rolled down his cheek. And that was when he first met Mr. Brown. Mr. Brown was a famous fashion designer. When he saw Moose looking so sad, he lent him his hanky. "Sorry to be a crybaby," sniffed Moose, as he explained about losing Monty. "Not at all," said Mr. Brown. "And if I lost my brother, I'd need an elephant hanky to dry my eyes." "An elephant hanky," said Moose. "Is there such a thing?" Mr. Bruce wiped out his sketchbook. I've designed a lot of range, he said. Elephant hankies for blowing trunks, hippo hankies to wipe muddy nostrils, and that's for crocodile tears. Who is the tiny hanky for, squinted Moose? A bumblebee bat, said Mr. Brown, waving a magical glass. She also wants more waterproof clothes to stop the rain going up her nose when she hangs upside down. I'm working on the design in London. I'd love to see it, said Mr. Moose. They came to my studio, said Mr. Brown, and then after that I had to travel to work. If you'd like to keep my company, I'll help you look for Monty. Moose had never been to London before. It was nothing like Alaska. He never seen anything like Mr. Brown's studio either. It was crammed from floor to ceiling with fantastic bits and bobs. Moose sniffed the air. There was a wonderful woof of wood, books, cotton, and something else. What was it? That's called imagination, said Mr. Brown. Now follow me. Mr. Brown's team was busy working on the bumblebee bat outfit. On the deck was a model of a teeny bat wearing a teeny coat and a teeny hat. Perfect, said Mr. Brown. The coat is what? Rainproof, and the hat doesn't fall off. Well done, everybody. Mr. Brown said, Moose, if you can make the hats for bats, I bet you can make anything for anyone. Parkas for penguins, sneakers for cheetahs, scarves for giraffes. What a brilliant idea, Moose said, Mr. Brown. I'll create a new range of clothes for creatures. Clothes that make their lives better, he said. And I want you on my team. Me, said Moose. I'd love to. Sunglasses for snakes, go faster slippers for sloths, and lots more besides. I'll help you find some new animals to help you while we look for Monty. Thanks for believing in me, Mr. Brown. Moose was demanding not to let Mr. Brown down. When they landed in Japan, he found a flying squirrel who lost her tail and couldn't get off the ground. Don't worry, I'm Mr. Brown. Can design you some trousers with a floppy tail, said Moose. And Mr. Brown did. The smiling squirrel flew from tree to tree. Can you see my twin brother from up here? Called Moose. But the answer was no. Monty wasn't in Australia either. Sorry, mate. But the kangaroos, I'm so grateful for the new Dungees, but I've looked everywhere and there's no sign of your brother. Never mind, Moose, said Mr. Brown. Perhaps we'll have better luck in. New York. There, Moose found a skunk who wanted perfume pants. a bald eagle in need of a bobble hat, and a bear desperate for snowshoes, but he couldn't find Monty anywhere. That night, while Moose slept, Mr. Brown crept out to find the bear. "Do you have friends in Alaska?" he asked. The bear nodded. So Mr. Brown described Monty. "He's missing and may have gone home to wait for his twin," he said. "If your friends find him, let me know and I'll give you a free buns for life." "That's a deal," said Bear. Next stop, Africa. The lion was thrilled with his pajamas as it was surprisingly cold at night. The Indian spitting cobra was delighted with his bib. And in China, the panda who lost her species loved the new ones with new ones. Mr. Brown designed, or specs. "If only Monty was here," sighed Moose, when they arrived in Paris. "I'm sure he'll turn up," said Mr. Brown, smiling. "To cheer you up, I've reserved a front seat for you at my fashion show tomorrow." The queue for Mr. Brown's show went around the block. Everyone wanted to know where he got his ideas from. "I can find inspiration in anything," he said. This time it came from Marvelous Moose. Everyone clapped and cheered when the models hit the catwalk. There was a giraffe, bear, panda, skunk, snake, all strutting their stuff. And then, in the grand finale, on March, the world next motto, he looked very much like Moose, and with a stylish swagger, he twirled ten of Mr. Brown hats on his antlers. "Oh, Monty, my Monty!" Moose cried with joy. You found him, Mr. Brown. How can I ever thank you?" "You already have," grinned Mr. Brown. "I've given you my dream team, the Moose Twins." Aw, well, found his brother, huh? Have you ever lost somebody like that? Let me know with a thumbs up if you ever lost anybody like that. If you've been separated from your twin brothers and stuff, or sister. Well, everybody, I hope all of you enjoyed this story time, and if you did, give it a thumbs up. Share it. If you're new and you came along this story time, hit that red subscribe button down below and subscribe to my channel. But until next time, they call me Mr. Bookman, and this book reading's over. Have a good one, and take care, everybody.